همای امروز میهن اسیر را در سه سیمای خجستش نمایندگی میکند.
And I do question his religious sincerity. No man can be a man of God that is a mass murderer. That's completely hypocritical. And then he asked people to sacrifice their life for the cause of tyranny. But does he sacrifice his life? He's not the one going out there and doing the suicide bombings, nor are the fat mullahs who are living wonderful lives off the misery of their own people. This has to be recognized, and it's only going to be recognized with the advocacy of a group like the NCRI and MEK.
Let me say, therefore, that we have reached a point where we can conclude, after all that has been tried with this criminal syndicate that is holding the people in history and culture of Iran hostage, that everything that has been tried has not worked. And since the regime in Tehran has proven itself that it will not change.
And you can hear in cities and towns all across Iran today a common message. Reformers, hardliners, the game is up. The game is up. It is over. Or simply, give us our country back. The Shah, the mullahs, dictators all, give us our country back.
And the regime is not strong. It is weakening. Today, its allies from Lebanon to Syria and Iraq and Yemen and Gaza are experiencing enormous economic pain and popular unrest. And of course, with the economic situation deteriorating at home, corruption rampant with explosions and fires widely reported, street protests continue to break out in Iran itself.
Parce que nous avons des choses en commun. Et ce que nous avons en commun, c'est notre volonté de défendre les valeurs humaines, de défendre les valeurs de la démocratie, de défendre les valeurs de la liberté, de défendre les valeurs de la recherche de la paix. C'est ça ce que nous avons en commun et c'est ce que nous voulons pour l'Iran. Nous voulons que les Iraniennes et les Iraniens puissent, comme nous, dans nos différents pays.
I want to send my very best wishes to NCRI and to President-elect Maryam Rajavi for her inspirational work on the international scene on behalf of the people of Iran at this very, very difficult time.
I am here to speak for all those voices which cannot be heard, mothers, daughters, fathers, sons, and Albanian families. I want to say that Camp Liberty in Albania, you are part of our family. You are in our faith. An unwritten law stands back of each one who fights to defend freedom. Mujahideens are not the problem of Iran. They are a flag of the future freedom of their country.
We support the Iranian people's desire for change and commend Madam Rajavi's 10-point plan for the future of Iran, which offers the people of Iran a free, secular, and democratic country. We thank you, Madam Rajavi, and all of you sacrificing for that future. You can continue to count on our fullest measure of support.
Likewise, the recent acts of psychological war and demonization campaigns by the mullahs prove that today the mullahs' regime is weaker than ever and that it is heading toward the end it deserves. For all this, your nation's trust in the NCRI and President Rajavi and the regime's horror at your freedom movement are greater than ever.
تروریسم رژیم در سایه سکوت کتمان تجاهل چشم بستن و به روی خود نیاوردن رشد پیدا میکنه.
Finally, we need to recognize that terrorism is a part of the fabric of this regime in Tehran. It has been since the start and remains so today. This means that things like Iranian embassies and so-called diplomats will continue to be employed in supporting terror. Countries must act accordingly to very closely monitor and surveil the activities of those Iranian diplomats posted abroad. And in some cases, like we have seen in Albania, they will need to shut down embassies that support terrorism.
I also think we should express thanks and appreciation to the leadership of all the political parties in Albania who've given home to the people at Ashraf 3 and provided facilities for PMOI and the NCRI to meet and to ensure that the true voice of the Iranian people is heard loud and clear right across the world.
Hi, I'm Texas Senator John Cornyn. Thank you for having me today, and what a privilege it is to speak to all of you as you continue to fight for a free Iran. America stands in full solidarity with the people of Iran and fully supports their desire to be a free people, as evident in the uprisings we've seen in the last few years.
Thank you for virtually having me at the Free Iran Global Summit, Iran Rising for Freedom. During my 2018 campaign, I was often asked about where I stood on U.S. foreign policy, and I always pointed to Iran as an adversary we were handling too lightly, as a threat to our national security and leader in human rights abuses. We must be harsh with Iran.
Dear Madam Rajavi, dear friends, it is always a great pleasure to be with you and friends from around the world. I am really proud and honored to be one of the first Albanians to support the transition from Ashraf to Albania with some other friends. And I can tell you that what makes this great is that all political parties in Albania really support MEK and Iranian Resistance. And I see a lot of good friends of mine being present in this conference.
The dictatorship in Iran fears the great uprising of November 2019 and the scenario of an escalation of the next uprising. The international community, as well as Albania, must recognize the right of Iranian people and the resistance to establish freedom and democracy in Iran.
It's a honor to be here today, and I believe that it's a honor and is a human obligation to join the voices that support the Iranian resistance, that they support the resistance of people, that they fight for democracy and for human rights and for a non-nuclear country.